it's been quite the journey. I mean, I actually wrote it 5 years ago, 5 or 6 years ago originally. It was a reaction to I saw this phenomenon kind of beginning where fans would rally around Farscape and would be able to meet each other and communicate and come together via online. And it was wonderful to see, and really this kind of wonderful fan family started to develop. But then naturally, as my head tends to go, what if it wasn't like this kind of wonderfully warm, sci-fi adventure show? It was something a little darker and edgier. What kind of fans would that come in? And that's kind of what started down the path of creating Cult. I would have, at the time, 5 years ago, whatever, would have been thrilled to have the show on then. But to be very honest, the timing now is absolutely perfect, because social media as a rallying point for fans has just exploded. And it's just very helpful to us. CW as well. They're so into using social media as a rallying point for the series. All this is heightened the experience of the show. Back when I wrote it before, people would essentially communicate via email and blogs, that sort of thing. Now it's like people communicate instantly. And just in talking to the marketing folks at CW about just how instantaneous that is, and how the Twitter communication during the show can impact viewership. Fascinating. And every time I hear this, I can salivate because it's so fascinating with the concept of the show. The perfect timing is perfect. And CW really is the perfect venue for us, because they are such a young audience, and they are exactly who we're talking about in the show. The inspiration was, as writers, we're always trying to connect with the audience on a visceral level. And we usually do that through drama, through emotion, through humor. As I started to kind of form the idea for this show, I thought, here's a chance to connect with a visceral level that I've never quite seen before. Films like Paranormal Activity and things like that are kind of found footage, which kind of create that sense of, am I seeing, Blair Witch, am I seeing things real or not real? Nobody ever really kind of accomplished that on television. And I thought, okay, here's an opportunity to really kind of blur that line, so that as you're watching the show, you'll see things on the inside show, and they're all here in the room, and the world, and back and forth. And the intent is really to kind of create for you, the audience watching at home, the sense that I'm not really in control of my viewing experience like I am in normal shows. I watched the show, I showed to my family a while back. And my son and had a girlfriend over, and they're like 19. And he walked her out to her car. It was nighttime. He walked her out to her car afterwards. And he came back, and I said, why? He goes, she's actually kind of scared walking to her. And I'm thinking, great, I'm thrilled, I guess. But why was she scared? Because the show's creepy. It's so scary. It's scary. It's creepy. Yeah. And I said, why was she scared? And she goes, because walking to the car, she really expected these elements that she had seen in the show to be out on the street with her. So it's exactly what I was hoping it would do, which is, even though after you watch the show, it doesn't necessarily leave you. It's still, the experience is kind of still there. So even as you watch the next show, or get up and go walk away from the TV, it kind of comes with you. And the notion of making the television, the very thing that we allow into our living room, and in our kids' bedroom, and in, we carry it in our hand, and making that something that's potentially dangerous, it's, to me, it's just so incredibly delicious. I can't tell you. So. The casting, I tell you, it just came together so beautifully. Jessica Lucas, first person we cast in it, she was our anchor. Nepper was something we always wanted. I love the fact that Robert, because of his history in playing edgy characters, brings a whole, his own kind of level of meta to it. Alona Tall was someone that was shooting a series in Israel, and we saw her on tape. And we're looking for tapes and things. And she came on, and I thought I was watching the show. She was so absolutely, I was like, there she was. And then Matt Davis was always the prototype for me that I didn't think I could have. So I could say, who's the Matt Davis type person? Then we heard from the CW that he was going to be a fan of me. And I was like, excited. And my daughter, who's like a huge Fire Islands fan. So I call her. And I'm thinking, this is who I got to play, you know, lead in. Matt Davis. And it was hilarious because she goes, you got Matt Davis? And then he's leaving Vampire. It was hilarious. I was like, so I left the first, whatever brick bats I will take for having Stone and Matt away from Vampire, I got it full force, you know, in my house. Well, yeah.